I think that the last thing he wants now is a Cold War.
President Biden is waking up back here at the White House, and his team is heralding this trip as a success, including that high-stakes summit with Russian President Vladimir Putin. And while the two leaders did keep things cordial, they didn't actually resolve any of their differences. The U.S. and Russia still firmly divided.
I did what I came to do.
After more than 2.5 hours, both sides giving their talks a positive review.
I think there was no hostility, quite the contrary. The talks were quite constructive.
But Putin still defiant, denying all responsibility for cyber attacks and interfering in U.S. elections. And when pushed by our Rachel Scott on his crackdown on his political opponents, Putin deflecting, pointing to the Black Lives Matter movement in the U.S. and the January 6th attack on the Capitol.
Mr. President, what are you so afraid of?
And an entire movement developed known as Black Lives Matter. I'm not going to comment on that, but here's what I do want to say. What we saw was disorder, destruction, violations of the law. We don't want that to happen on our territory.
You didn't answer my question, sir. If all of your political opponents are dead, in prison, poison, doesn't that send a message that you do not want a fair political fight?
People came to the U.S. Congress with political demands. 400 people. Over 400 people had criminal charges placed on them.
Biden says he didn't issue threats, but says he made clear to Putin there will be consequences if he doesn't change his ways.
The bottom line is, I told President Putin that we need to have some basic rules of the road that we can all abide by.
And on cybersecurity, after those attacks that crippled a U.S. gas pipeline and targeted the meat industry, Biden says critical infrastructure should be off limits, giving Putin a list of 16 prohibited areas from the energy sector to the water supply. And he's warning Putin the U.S. stands ready to retaliate.
40 million Americans are feeling the effect of a dangerous heat wave. On Wednesday, record high temperatures were shattered in California, Arizona, Utah, and Montana, where Billings hit 105 degrees, tying the city's hottest June day ever. Just south of Billings, the dramatic picture showing flames in the mountains above the city of Red Lodge. One of two large fires burning in Montana, California's Death Valley is the record holder for the hottest temperature ever recorded on Earth, 134 degrees back in 1913. The forecast for Death Valley this week, flirting with that record, with temperatures in the mid-120s. The heat now baking areas already parched by extreme drought. With no rain in sight, lakes and reservoirs that millions of people rely on for their water supply are drying up. ABC's Matt Gutman is at Folsom Lake in California.
At about this time last year, this entire boat ramp was underwater, but the drought so severe this year that Folsom Lake has shrunk. And now you've got to go a quarter mile in that direction just to find water's edge.